Yeah, he certainly was, Stephen Hendry. And we've spoken quite a bit about Stephen and indeed his outstanding record here at Wembley, winning the tournament five times in a row between 1989 and 1993. But it all very nearly came a cropper against Mike Hallett back in 1991.
He's beaten Alan McManus, Neil Foles and Terry Griffiths to reach today's final. He's ranked number 7 in the world, Mike Hallett.
Mike Hallett was, like myself, unfortunate to play in the era of the great Davis and Hendry. In fact, in the 88 Masters final, he was whitewashed 9-0 by the Nugget. But to his credit, 3 years later, he was back for more.
Ranked number 1 in the world, Stephen Hendry.
This time he faced Stephen Hendry, who had already beat JP in two previous finals. The golden burn was in his pomp. He didn't expect Mike Hallett to start the way he did.
17 frames to go. Well, a terrific break there for the start of the final from Mike Hallett.
Mike's having a double here.
What?
I didn't think he drank. Terrific performance as Mike Hallett goes to tee, leading 4-0.
So just the pink. Well, if Stephen pops the pink here, it's going to go automatically behind the black. It's all about the pink. Well, fate took a hand there. So well done, Stephen. A very vital frame indeed. 7-1, Mike Hallett leads. The applause certainly tells everything, doesn't it? They really keyed up tonight. And that was a great pink. Oh, and what a relief there for Mike Hallett. That's the one he's been waiting for.
At 8-2 up, Mike must have been thinking that this was his moment, his chance to win. It came down to the colours and it looked like Stephen was going to lose his first match at Wembley.
So 21 points behind and 22 remaining.
43. 48.
Again, rather tentative, maybe a little bit of elbow in that. And how anxious now is Stephen? Look at this. Now, has it got away?
Mike Hallett.
Well, the cheer goes up. And Stephen Hendry pulls another one back. It is now 8-3.
Stephen Hendry's one player you didn't want to let off the hook. His break building and attacking aggressive play put you under so much pressure. Was Mike Hallett going to get another chance?
Fourteen.
Stephen takes a deep breath. It's there. A magnificent performance by the world champion as once again he comes back, now trailing by 4 frames only at 8 frames to 4.
Should have been a 9-3 winner.
He's obviously getting a little anxious. He's seen this this lead whittled away.
One.
Anybody got a rope?
Well, he might feel like hanging himself if he loses. Will, as they say in the snooker world, do his head in if he loses after being 7-0 up at the interval.
Two, Mike Hallett.
Of Masters titles. Yeah! The great comeback. Mike Hallett led 7-0 and 8-2. He was within 2 pots of winning 9-2. But Stephen Hendry, world champion of the years, hung on and hung on and hung on and has won by 9 frames to 8.
Well, he had good reason to be pleased with himself after that remarkable comeback, but I don't think we've ever seen emotion like that from Stephen Hendry before.
In the history of snooker collapses, this one ranks pretty high. And to cap off a great day for Mike, he also found out that his home had been burgled.
Yes, when